So now the centrifuge has been done and the washing, that is washing is done. Now we will discard the water. I have already discarded the water of other samples. Now we will put proteinase K buffer, that is PKB buffer in it. And this is the pipette of 20 to 200. So we will take it and put it. Put 150 microliter of proteinase buffer. And 10 microliter of 10% S. This is taken pipette of 2 to 20 range. From this we will put 10 microliter of SDS. Now by tapping we will dissolve the pellet and make a homogeneous mixture. So in from PKB and after putting PKB and SDS we have homogenized the mixture and it looks like this. Now it has formed a homogeneous mixture. In this we will add 100 microliter of NaCl, chilled NaCl. Chilled is the requirement. Chilled NaCl 100 microliter and 240 microliter of water will be added. After adding all these, so overall we have added PKB, SDS, 5M NaCl and water. Now we will close the lid and mix it well. After mixing these ingredients, we will form, then add phenol and chloroform to it. Chloroform is light sensitive, so we put it in a dark bottle, and dark bottle is made by wrapping the bottle with aluminium foil. And in this we can so this is 400 microliter of phenol, and in here we have to keep in mind that phenol can burn the skin, so we have to take the precaution that we do not drop it on our skin, then it will form a boil. So we will add 400 microliter of phenol, saturated phenol. The phenol is saturated with the help of EDTA. This 0.5 m EDTA, so EDTA is present at the as top layer in this bottle, so we have to take precaution that EDTA does not come in the tip while pipetting. We have to keep in mind that just phenol comes. Now we will add 100 microliters of chloroform, that is phenol and chloroform are added in 4:1 ratio, 4 parts of phenol and 1 part of chloroform. And this method of DNA isolation is called salting out method. After adding phenol and chloroform, we just have to mix all the thing like this. We do not put pressure in here, otherwise our genetic material will get sheared. To get the DNA intact, we just mix it like this and keep it for 1 minute and then centrifuge for 15 minutes at 10,000 RPM.
centrifugation has been done. Here you can see the clear supernatant and all the other impurities settled down at the bottom. With careful, put it in the stand. Now here you can see the, all the impurities are settled down at the bottom, and in the supernatant, we will separate the supernatant in next tube and like this. Carefully we will separate it. We have to carefully separate the supernatant so that the white layer that you can see should not come with the supernatant. See, the slight supernatant which is left, we will not take that out as there is possibility of white layer getting disturbed, and then our supernatant will be contaminated with other things. In this, you can see the clear supernatant. Likewise, we will separate all the samples. Now, to the separated supernatant, we will add 1 ml of alcohol to precipitate the DNA. Now we have added 100% alcohol to the supernatant, and by mixing it like this, the DNA will be precipitated. Now you can see in here that this is the DNA. That white thing which is present in the appendage is the DNA thread. The DNA in pellet form, we will centrifuge the DNA for 5 minutes at 10,000 RPM. Here you can see RPM is equal to 1000. So 10 into 1000 is 10,000. Now we will switch it on. Now after centrifugation, we can see the DNA in the pellet form settled at the bottom. This white point which is seen in the tube is the DNA. Now we will discard all the alcohol, this white spot is the DNA. Now we will discard all the alcohol and wash it with 70% alcohol for two times and let it dry overnight, and then next day we will add TE buffer, 50 microliter TE buffer to it and let it dissolve at 55 degree temperature for 1 hour. Put 300 microliters of 70% alcohol and we will wash it for 3 minutes by centrifuging it at 10,000 RPM for 3 minutes. Now after 3 minutes, we will discard the 70% alcohol and let it dry for at 37 degrees Celsius for overnight.